So we'll start on question number four. The table below shows the cumulative distribution of gross weekly earning of male full-time workers in Zambia Sugar Company in April 2020. Estimate the distribution: A, the median earning of a manual worker; B, the median earning of a non-manual worker; and C, the proportion of manual workers earning less than the median earning of non-manual workers. So first and foremost, we're just going to draw this table that we have been given here. So this table has gross weekly earning, manual workers, and non-manual workers. I'll start with this table. So we have the columns as follows. This column here is the column for gross weekly earning, and then this column I have written just MW in brackets frequency. This is the column for manual workers, and now that F is just the frequency. Let me just remove this bracket because some of you might think as if I'm talking about the function. Let me just write F there to show that I'm talking about frequency of manual workers, and then this is the cumulative frequency of manual workers, and then this is now, this column is for non-manual workers. F there is the frequency. So that's just our frequency. So that is our frequency. And then this is the cumulative frequency for non-manual workers. Okay, so we have these columns here. So now this, for us to find the cumulative frequency, I'm sure we all know. So we just see, we can, okay, let's just find, best of all, find the summation of our frequency, sum of LPA. You add everything here and the sum, looking at time, I'll just write the actual figure. The sum there is 27,800. And then the sum here is equals to summation of F is equals to 14,900. Those are people, not money. So sum of F is simply equals to that. So now for the frequencies, we'll start the process. So cumulative frequency. So our frequency will have 100. So you start with 100. So the next one here can be 100 plus 300 is 400. 400 plus 700 is 11,000. No, not 11,000. 1,100. This plus this is 2,400. This plus this is 4,400. This plus this is 7,100. And then this plus this is 11,100. This plus this, 16,000. This plus this, 21,700. And then this plus this, it's 27. So if I tell you, add everything, and then your answer that you're going to get here is not equal to this. That's not to say it's either this is wrong or that is wrong. So every time these two are supposed to be the same. That is if I tell you are doing it in ascending order. If I tell you are doing it in ascending order. And if I tell you go up like this, because this was supposed to be on top. So now we are done with this column. And then we move to this column, which is here. So the procedure is just the same. We start with 100. 100, 300, 700. This plus this is 13. Then this plus this is what? 0022. And then this and this is 3,400. This plus this 002. 576.
this and this, we have 0, 0, 8, 10, this and this, we have 14, 9, and 8.
So we have done, we have completed our table. So after we've completed the table, now we answer our questions now. Unless there's a question on completing the table and find it easy. What we just did here is just that we just added the cumulative frequencies for manual workers and the cumulative frequencies for non-manual workers. That's what we've just done. So we are done with that. So let's look at the question. Look at question number A, and it's requiring us to find the median earning of manual workers. So now median earning of manual workers. So now how do we find the median in the base space? So now for us to find the median, we have first of all to look at the value of N, the value of capital N, or which is just capital N, which is just equals to summation of F. Is the value that we have found, is it an even number or an odd number? In this case, when we look at summation of F, it is 27,000 for manual workers, just 27,800, which is an even number. So if it is an even number, to find the median is just the this summation of N over 2, the N over 2 observation, that is the median in this case. So we have to find the N over 2 observation. So now how do we go about finding the same?
So summation of F, so first of all, median. So are we,
for manual workers, I'm going to abbreviate manual workers. It just MW.
So manual workers, I say MW is equals to the N over 2, I just say summation of F over 2, observation. So this is equals to summation of F is this 27,800 over 2. Remember, it's not the value.
That's not the value, it's just the observation.
So the answer here is supposed to be 13,900 observation. So the median is at the median is found at this position, 13,900. So now, after we've found that, we are not done. What we do is, and just twist it a bit like that. So what we do here next is, we go to the cumulative frequencies for manual workers. The cumulative frequencies for manual workers, we have this. So we'll start looking at the value here that is equal to 13,900 or slightly greater than 13,900. But sometimes some people they just add, for example, they don't find the actual value. They can add these two and then divide by two and then to find the value. But in this case, we're not going to do that. We're just going to look for the value that is slightly greater than 13,900 in the case where we don't find the actual value amongst these cumulative frequencies that we have. So we have 100. So we look at these. So here we have 11,100. Here we have 16. So you are seeing that this is greater than this. It's also smaller than this. So we'll consider this 16. This is the kinetic. So now we are talking about earning. These are just kinetic frequencies. Earning is found here. Gross weekly earning. So you get the value from here, but we have to follow. Since you are talking of this value here. Like if when the cumulative frequency is 16,000, what is the earning? Is this? It's 80 kwacha. So the median earning is 80 kwacha. So you just write it. Therefore, median for manual workers is just the 80 kwacha. So that's the median for manual workers, 80 kwacha. Unless there's a question before we calculate the median for non-manual workers. Unless there's a question. Okay, since there's no question, I'm going to wrap this and then so for non-manual workers. So I can just write it aside. I'll just say the median.
Excuse me, madam.
Just a minute. Median for manual workers. Madam. Just a minute. It's 80 kwacha. Yes. Median for manual workers here, it's 80 kwacha. So now I'll wrap this. Now already, I'll find the median earning now for non-manual workers. For non-manual workers, So for non-manual workers, the formula will still be the same, because when you look at the summation of non-manual workers, it's here. Non-manual workers to find it's 14,900, which is even. So we're also going to divide it by two.
So we divide that by two. So you have 14,900 divided by two. Remember, this is not the actual value, it's just an observation. So you have to show that it's not the actual value, it's just an observation.
So it will give us something like 7,450
observation.
So now after we found the observation for 7,450, now we go to the cumulative frequency for non-manual workers, which is this. So we look for a place where this can be found, 7,450. So you look at this. So here we have 5,2. Here we have 7,6. But we are looking for 7,4. So 7,4 is supposed to be in between 5,2 and 7,6. Therefore, we are just going to pick the value that is greater than it. So we just pick 7,600. So for this 7,600, you see the cumulative. What was the earning here? Because you're looking for median earning. So this is the value. And now earning, you get your earning from here. So it used to be 80 kwacha. So the median earning now is equals to median earning for non-manual workers is equals to 80 kwacha. So we found the median earning for non-manual workers and the median earning for manual workers. So we have found question A and question B. And let's take the question before we conclude question number four. We look at question number C. So question number C is talking us. Okay, before I go to question number C. So guys, allow me to wrap everything that we have here. Then I'm just writing the values on top. So I can just create some space for myself. So we have median earning for non-manual workers is equals to 80 kwacha. Median earning for manual workers is equals to 80 kwacha also. Equals to 80 kwacha. So the proportion of manual workers, guys, because it's the proportion of manual workers earning less than the median earning of non-manual workers. So we are looking for the proportion of those manual workers who are earning less than the median earning of non-manual workers. So you are expected, first of all, to know the median earning of non-manual workers. After you've known the median earning for manual workers, now find the people who are getting the number of manual workers who were earning less than that amount. How many were they? So now we'll look at this. So let me, I want to create space for myself. Okay, yes, do this. Do I need this? Which one do I need? Okay, I'll just remove this column so I can create space for my calculations. Since I will no longer need it. So now we have this. So proportion of manual workers earning less than, okay. Proportion of manual workers earning less than median earning of non-manual workers. So this is just equals to the number of manual workers. The number of manual workers earning less than 80 kwacha, because we know to the median earning for the not less or equals to, it's just less than. We know to the median earning for non-manual workers, the median earning was 80 kwacha, isn't it? So now we are looking for the people who are getting, who the non-manual workers who are getting less than 80 kwacha. So now we have to find the number of manual workers earning less than 80 kwacha divided by total number of, well, since we are looking for proportion, total number of manual workers. Total number of manual workers. So now, number of workers earning less than 80 kwacha. Number of non-manual workers. So manual workers are here. So we're looking for the number of those manual workers who are earning less than 80 kwacha. So 80 kwacha is here. So now we'll start from here. So 4,900 manual workers were getting 80 kwacha. So those who are not getting this 80 kwacha are those that start from this point. From this point going up. From this point going up, the people were getting less than 80 kwacha. But starting from this point going up, these people were getting more than 80 kwacha, more than the median earning of non-manual workers. So your task is to calculate, you add this up to the far end. And then after that, you divide by the total number of all these for us to find the proportion. So when you add all these, so you have 100 plus up to the last number here is supposed to be 4,000. Over, you add all these 100 plus, remove this because you might end up being confused. 100 plus 300 plus dash. The last number here is supposed to be 661. So when you add everything there, you're going to get 11,100 divided by 27,800. When you reach at this stage here, you don't even have to stretch to say, how am I going to just start calculating? If I tell you I found your cumulative here, you can ask because this 11 pin that you see, it's just the sum of all this. I think from this point up to this point, it's 11,000. This that is here is just the sum of everything that is here. So when you add all this, you're going to get 0.399, which is just the same as 0.4. But as a percentage, this is just 40%. So 40% of manual workers were getting the money that was less than 80 kwacha. 40% of those manual workers are getting less than 80 kwacha. That's what that simply means about the proportion. Unless there's a question before you move to question number 5. Any question, guys? If there's no question, let's look at question number 5. I'm sure I can put question number 5 first. So question number 5, talking about prove the formula, as I mentioned, of x minus x bar squared. This is simply equal to summation of x squared minus n x bar. So we'll prove it using this side. So left hand side. Summation of x minus x bar squared. First and foremost, we are going to distribute, we're going to expand this. So it's a summation. So when you expand this, it will be to square this, to square this. And then lastly, you multiply this, multiply by this, multiply by negative x bar. So we'll start with x squared. What is this? The square of x squared is just x squared. The next is the square of negative mean squared, it is just plus mean bar squared. Then lastly, 2 multiplied by x multiplied by negative x bar. It's negative 2 mean x. We've expanded. So after we've done the expansion, we are going to distribute the summation across. So this is going to be summation of x squared, summation and x squared. So now guys, here is a situation. Summation of x squared, that's just a constant. It's not a variable, it's a constant. So now since it's a constant, it will just be n. For example, let me give you a practical example. You have x, summation of x. Can I say? Summation of who? Summation of one. Summation of one. And then this one here, you're going to add ones from I up to one up to n like that. So when you add these ones, yes, it's a constant, it will just be one plus one plus one plus one plus up to the n value of one. So now if I tell you it was going up to 10, if it was going up to 10 here, it would have been plus one plus one up to 10 plus one like that. So now if I tell you have the same value, one up to 10. So this is just the same. If I not use one, this might get one. I may use two. So you have two plus two up to the 10th two. So now this is this part. This is the same as it. Since there are 10 of them, we just say 10 multiplied by what? Two. To just be 10 multiplied by two. Similarly, if I tell you happen to have this summation, you happen to have summation of x bar squared, and this is running from I is equals to one up to n. Up to n. So this will just be x bar squared up to the last value plus x bar squared. And all these, they're supposed to have any of these values, since these are constants. So they're supposed to have any of these. So now, instead of me writing this squared, it's just as good as just me writing. I just write one and then multiply everything by n. So this will just be n x bar squared. Since these are constants, this is the mean, it's constant. But you can't write n if you are dealing with x, which is a variable. Take note of that. So now this brings us to this here. Summation of x bar, it is just plus n squared. I've explained it, I'm not going to explain it again. Next, summation of this. So you have